Good afternoon, and welcome to Sacred Hearts Parish. We welcome those present here at church and also those attending Mass via live stream at home. My name is Joe DeMore. Barbara Costello and I will be your lectors this afternoon. We gather today as a community of believers to celebrate God's great gifts to us, God's Word and the Eucharist. Today we celebrate the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider is Father Dan, assisted by Deacon Gill. Our Mass intention is for Gerald A. and Rosalind P. Begley. Our second collection today is for retired women religious who have served our Archdiocese faithfully as teachers, nurses, social workers, and more. Thank you for your generosity. Women are an important theme in today's liturgy. In addition to our second collection, women are the subject of today's reading from Proverbs. In particular, the reading extols the value of a worthy wife. Our gospel then invites us to consider how we all act with our own gifts. Do we act in a way that is worthy of the gifts entrusted to us? In a spirit of hospitality, I invite you to now stand and greet those around you. Let us now give praise and glory to our God.
Please join in singing number 202, We Gather Together, number 202. Distressing, sing praises to his name, he forgets not his own. Beside us to guide us, our God with us joining, whose kingdom calls all to the love which endures. So from the beginning, the Father. Congregation, escape tribulation, your name be ever praised, O Lord, make us free.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, in the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives, who reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are those who Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are you. Shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your house. Your children like olive plants are Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief at night. When people are saying, peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing the additional 5. He said, Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come. Share your master's joy. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I was doing a funeral home service yesterday at one of the funeral homes here in the city, and as I got through my speech, there was this elderly woman there in her upper 80s, early 90s, and she spoke to her caregiver. She said, when is he gonna stop? So I said, right now. She only lives right over the bridge, so if you want to bring her here every other Saturday. In the second reading, Paul says, be alert and sober. Well, one aspect of this means to always be ready to say yes to whatever God may ask, trusting that his plans are better than our plans. During the Nazi invasion of Europe throughout World War II, many Christian families had this faith in God put to the test. The Postma family, a father and two children, were living in a small country village in Holland when the Nazi invaded and conquered their country. Initially, their lives were affected very little. But as the war continued, the Nazis instituted their cruel program of Jewish identification, deportation, and eventual extermination. Devout Christians, the Potsmas prayed fervently for God's intervention. Then, on a crisp March evening in 1943, their pastor paid them a visit. After some tea and small talk, the pastor's face became serious. "I want to tell you the real reason for my stopping by tonight," he said in a sober, hushed tone. "I was wondering if you would consider taking in someone," he said slowly. That someone, of course, was a Jew, a person to be hidden from not only snooping Gestapo agents, but even from their neighbors. A person to be fed, clothed, and entertained, but never revealed. A person whose mere presence in the home could result in a trip to the gas chamber or a bullet to the head for all of them. The Postmas knew that saying yes would mean living from then on with caution, deception, anxiety, and even terror as they dodged the Nazi search parties. What would we have said to that pastor? The Potsmiths said yes. They knew that it wasn't the pastor who was asking for their help. It was God. And as a result, a 22-year-old Jewish girl lived with the Potsmiths until the Nazi defeat in 1945. The Potsmiths, you see, were alert and sober. They recognized God's call in their life and responded with courageous generosity. The only thing we need to fear is not using our talents in the Lord's service. Now, some of you may know this last name. I didn't, but I'm not from Haverhill. And the fellow, Willard Lehman, and he was a coach and a gym teacher in the Haverhill school system, among others, within this vicinity. And so I had his funeral service yesterday. And I told the story before I was rudely interrupted about a deacon friend of mine, not Deacon Gill, but someone from Woburn. And he told me when I was in Woburn, he says, "I'm flying back home to Minnesota, and I'll be back tomorrow night." And I said, "Why? Why?" And he says, "My football coach died, my former football coach." And I said, "Can't you send a card, you know?" And he says, "No," he says, "you don't understand." He says, "My parents divorced, and my father abandoned our family. And this coach, my coach, became like a father figure to me." And so I would like to believe, and maybe it's your sense too, that coaches and teachers and medical professionals and even priests, and you can name any other segment of the population, music directors, music people gifted with music, that they have these innate talents already. And sometimes they discover them, sometimes other people discover them. Some people might not think they have any talents, but it's these innate talents that enable us to do the jobs that we do. And God gives us those talents. And as I said, the only thing to fear is not fear itself. The only thing to fear is not using our talents wisely, always in the service of other people.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We lift our hearts and voices to God our Father as we present to him our petitions and prayers.
For the church, may the Lord help us be faithful in our mission to be a light to the nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, may the Holy Spirit convict them in charity to share their resources with those who need them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who will be traveling this holiday weekend, may God grant them safety and peace, and may he give us hearts that are truly grateful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children waiting to be born and the mothers who carry them, and children waiting to be adopted, and the families who will receive them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Edward Clough, Willard Lehman, Madeline Scaglione, and Anthony Alexa, may God's love and mercy surround them and bring them to his everlasting kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Gerald A. and Rosaline P. Begley, who we especially remember at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers and concerns that we hold silently in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we humbly ask that in your compassion and mercy, you hear the prayers of your people. We ask this as in all things in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives, who reigns, God forever and ever.
Please join in singing number 439, You Are Near, number 439.
Oh,
my heart, and you know when I sit and when I stand. Your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you. Darkness before I saw the sun in my mother's womb. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Come on.
During communion, please join in singing number 344, God's Holy Gifts, number 344. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. May the body of Christ be food for our souls and bring us to everlasting life. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died. May the blood of the Lord protect us from harm and mark us as God's beloved ones. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come down to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. As the grain of this bread was gathered as one, may we who believe be bound by love. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. As the cup that we share is emptied for all, may we offer up our lives in love. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. When we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we hold in our memory Christ the Lord. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in our heart that he died for you.
Good afternoon. My name is Maureen Trainer, and I am here today to share a few words with you. Father John asked me to keep it short, and that is what I had planned to do. Each month, we have been highlighting the various ministries of our parish. Today, I will be sharing with you our greeter ministry. As you know, when you come in each week, there's always someone there to welcome you with a friendly hello. I'd ask that you look at this week's bulletin, and in the ministry article, you will see a few of the responsibilities of this the greeter ministry. I ask that you read it, think about it, and pray about it, as we all do God's work in his vineyard. Thank you.
Just a few announcements. Please join us for Mass on Thanksgiving Day. Mass will be this Thursday, November 23rd at 8 a.m. at Sacred Hearts Church. The Catholic Daughters are hosting a bake sale after all Masses this weekend, and the Knights of Columbus are hosting their annual Christmas wreath and swag sale after all Masses this weekend. Thank you for supporting these causes. Due to the Thanksgiving holiday, there will be no adoration this week on Friday.
Father John, Father Richard, and myself can all stand to lose some weight, so it is a mortal sin to buy anything from the bake sale and bring it over to the rectory. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord. Amen. And on behalf of Father John and Deacon Gill, myself, Father Richard, and our entire pastoral staff, we'd like to wish you and all of your loved ones a very blessed and happy Thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go forth glorifying God with your life.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing number 437, Though the Mountains May Fall. Number 437.